members have ever stuck in it. I was gonna do a bubblegum video, but remember them? Chocolate coins. I found a few stragglers. Right before Christmas, Ventura had a rogue wave event. And as I'm gawking, as I see everything on the news, never do I think. The grandkids, or their dad, are gonna be a part of the whole event. So, that morning, my daughter slept in, and they flew in and spent Christmas with us for a few weeks. And they always stay on the beach, some bed and breakfast spot on the beach. And the dad tells the grandkids, now remember what I told you, every 30 minutes, there's always a big wave that shows up. He's a surfer, and I guess there's some kind of rhythm to the waves that approximately every 30 minutes a big wave comes in. So anyways, a big wave had kind of just come and gone. So they said, okay, so let's keep our eye open. 30 more minutes, we're going to have another big wave. And within a few minutes, they're walking, and you guessed it. Big Brother was the first. He was playing in the water. I recorded him telling the story. And at the end of the video, I will play the audio. I will try my best to play the audio for you. So that's the plan now. So if for some reason the end of the video comes and you don't hear the audio, you'll just know that I couldn't do it so that it sounded nice enough to put on a video. So anyways, dad's walking, little sister's kind of ahead of him, and big brother is way ahead of them, and he's playing in the water, and the wave comes as he's playing in the water, and he can't get away quick enough, and it carries him, and as dad's trying to get big brother, little sister gets swept away. And she says they both got swept back to the river. And there's some parts of Ventura where the beach waves go and go far back, and there's no fence or homes or inclines, so where it forms like a little river kind of far away from the ocean shore. And they both say how they got swept and how little sister was wearing her ballerina. Remember I did the Amazon haul, and I showed you the ballerina carry bag and the ballerina socks and ballerina little ballerina dress. So that's what she was wearing that morning. And I'm thinking, oh my goodness, like, weren't they freezing? But I do know there's an element of like weather, humidity at times down there by the ocean. So they were having fun, and it swept them both up, pushed them back to the river. And I guess little sister was bobbing around under the water until she finally came up. I guess she had her arm up, she grabbed onto a pole or something, I don't know. But you can hear me this was a 2 or 3 days prior to Christmas, and I should have known that. You can hear my voice. I was just screaming and having a wonderful time with the kids, and I was asking them all about the details of the wave story. Grandpa never heard the wave story. I was laughing so hard, and even though I knew my throat was giving out, I couldn't keep quiet. So, you know, again, I learned my lesson again. If you recall, a few years back, I told the story of my daughter getting stuck in the swing. There's a park nearby, and we would walk to it. And one Sunday morning, my sweetheart wanted to read the paper. I said, okay, well, we'll be at the park. When you're done with the paper, meet us at the park. Good plan. But in the meantime, my daughter got stuck in the swing. We had to dial 911. Everybody came, an ambulance, the police department, the fire department, all these ambulances. Not a problem. My daughter was fine. We come home, and no sooner get in the house than my husband said, what in the world is going on out there? Did you hear all the sirens? I said, well, yes. Did you? Well, your daughter was stuck in the swing, and I had to know. How do you get stuck in the swing? And it was the swing, the plastic, where you put your feet in. You put very small kids in there, and like a plastic, and you put them in, and their legs go through. Well, somehow she squatted down and couldn't get her out. And by the time I figured out I couldn't get her out, her toes were purple, her feet were blue, her legs were like black and blue and purple. And so I panicked. But so anyways, I remember him like not being serious. I said, yes, see, it was for your daughter, and you were gawking. He says, I wasn't gawking. I said, well, remember I told you, you always be careful, because you never know what that ambulance is for and who it's going to rescue. Somebody needs help. And bigger than beans, if I didn't do the exact same thing that I lamp-basted him for with a bad attitude, the day the rogue waves hit, there's all these people, and the areas that they showed on TV or the news spots, all the areas we frequent, every single one of them is like a second home to us because we're nearby. So I realized I was gawking doing the same thing, only to find out a couple days later that those, for all I know, it could have been in those scenes of the people getting swept away. It could have been my grandkids, but I'm sure it wasn't. I'm sure the film they used on the TV wasn't my grandkids, but it just reminded me that you never know who's where, what's going on, and who may be hurt. So I still try to be mindful and thoughtful that, you know, not to gawk at stuff. And so that was a fun beach experience for grandson and granddaughter. So I'm going to try to get this going. And I'm going to key this up. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So we'll see how this goes.
About what happened to you in the wave?
The wave was, I was playing in the water, and then I didn't see this wave coming, so my dad warned me.
I saw the wave.
And then I looked at where the wave was, and then I was running into a wave, knocked me over in the river, and then I was under the water, and then I was swept away under
wait.
And she was showing under, and then she
you mean the wave pushed you all the way back to the river?
Wow.
He went under five waves.
And how long did you have to hold your breath underwater?
One minute.
So anyways, that was our fun few days right before Christmas, and you know, isn't it something? I'm still laughing when I hear them tell the story. I'm just grateful that we have those times in life, and I'm just so thankful no one ever gets injured. There's so many things that happen, you know, and we just have to be thankful. So, anyways, that was a fun end to our 2023. Good times. Nobody terribly injured. And, so thankful.
Hear the story about what happened to you in the wave.
The wave was, I was playing in the water, and then I didn't see this wave coming, so my dad warned me.
I saw the wave.
And then I looked where the wave was, and then I was running into a wave, knocked me over in the river, and then I was under the water, and then I was swept away under a
wave.
She was all showing under, and then she, and we lost her in the water, and her dad didn't know when she was in a pop-up. And then she popped up and grabbed onto this bus. And then our dad got her.
Dad is a hero. And now, little sister.
I'm stuck.
Little sister, what happened to you when the wave? Wait a minute. Do you mean the wave pushed you all the way back to the river?
Wow.
He went under five waves.
Went under five waves.
And how long did you have to hold your breath underwater?
One minute.
So anyways, that was our fun few days right before Christmas, and you know, isn't it something? I'm still laughing when I hear them tell the story. I'm just grateful that we have those times in life, and I'm just so thankful no one ever gets injured. There's so many things that happen, you know, and we just have to be thankful. So, anyways, that was a fun end to our 2023. Good times. Nobody terribly injured. And, so thankful.